than 40 years after her death, Patsy Cline remains the voice by which all other female country singers must measure themselves. Patsy transformed what it meant to be a female country star. She was born Virginia Patterson Hensley in the Shenandoah Valley of Virginia in 1932. As a teenager, she sang on local radio and dreamed of coming to Nashville on the Grand Ole Opry. Once she hit Nashville, the results were explosive. Patsy Cline scaled the pop charts with I Fall to Pieces, Crazy, She's Got You, and other hits. She headlined at Carnegie Hall, starred in Las Vegas, and played the Hollywood Bowl. This is Robert K. Orman. I've written 7 books about the history of music in Nashville, and Patsy Cline has been a big chapter in every one of them. But even after all these years, the words still do not come to adequately describe her extraordinary power as a vocalist. So maybe seeing is believing. What we're about to see is the very first televised performance by Patsy Cline. In 1955, Patsy recorded her first single, A Church, A Courtroom, and Then Goodbye. A year later, she came to Nashville to tape it for a Grand Ole Opry television show. She's just 23 years old at this time, but I think what you'll see is the larger-than-life voice is there. She's a fully formed talent. This is why she got a recording contract. She's still in her red-hot mama mode. It's a weeper, a ballad, and yet she delivers it with a sis-boom-bah high note at the end, which is the way she performed in those days. Later, she became much more subtle with her phrasing and everything else, but there's no question that the talent is here in this performance.
Excuse me, Whitman, thank you very much for that fine job. And now, neighbor, I think I'll go right back over here and visit with my good friend Ernest Dove and see if I can't find out who this lovely young lady is.
Why, thank you, Jimmy. In fact, I want you, Jimmy, and all the folks to meet this lovely young lady because she's our special guest tonight from Virginia. Fine recording artist for the Coral People, and her name is Patsy Cline.
Patsy Cline, how are you, Patsy?
Just fine.
Nice to see you. And the bell rings for now, Ernest. This is the young lady you've been telling us so much about.
Right you are, Jimmy. This is the young lady that I've been bragging about. And Patsy, I think that you should give the folks a sample of this fine singing of yours that I've been talking so much about. How about it, huh?
Well, thank you, Ernest. I'd like to do one of my favorites that I recorded some time back. A church, a courtroom, and then goodbye. Thank you.
Patsy Cline preferred upbeat, more rocking songs. This is what she performed in the clubs for years. This is what got the people dancing and got the people drinking. This is what was her meal ticket. She thought that she was a pro at really selling these upbeat numbers, and she was great at it. And Come On In was one of those songs. Come On In was a single for her, and she liked it so much that it became her lifelong show opener. It was like, come on in, let's get the party started. It's joyous, it's fun, it's upbeat, it's positive. She really didn't favor the downbeat stuff quite yet, and you can feel her joy in performing the song when you watch this. She's just so full of herself and so fun. The very ending is great, where she kind of like looks into the camera and really sells it. It's also Patsy in her classic look. The full red lips, the bouffant hair, the tight dress. She's just got it going on in this.
Well, that's fun.
Well, thank you.
But I can't understand why you sing us this beautiful song to such beautiful girl, parked way out here in a Surrey, and you don't even have a horse to pull it.
Well, I'll tell you how it is. You know, nowadays, a boy gets a girl, and he goes out, and he finds a lonely spot,
yeah,
and he runs out of gas.
Yeah.
Back in my day, you found a lonely spot and you run out of horses.
I hadn't thought of it that way.
Well, you should. You'll approach it sometime.
It's good to introduce me.
Well, I guess you have. Patsy Cline, do you know Ferlin Husky?
Hi, Ferlin.
Hoss, you just been replaced.
Oh, really?
Hi, Ferlin. Come on in. I wish I could go back to my home neighborhood, where the good folks, they all love you as their own. Then I'll go over to my neighbor's house, knock on the door, they'd all sing out, come on in and sit right down and make yourself at home. I'd sing their praises long and loud, cause they're all my folks and I'm mighty proud of the little old town back home where I was born. I wish that I could hear them say in the good old someone's on the judgment day, I hope I can hear my Savior say, come on in and sit right down and make yourself at home. Now come on in and sit right down and make yourself at home.
We're lucky that Patsy Cline came along when she did, because television was in its infancy. And the new medium needed performances, in particular musical performances. People loved watching singers on television. And country music in particular was favored by this. And there were lots of these regional programs around. One of them was Ranch Party out in Los Angeles. And Patsy Cline went there in 1957 to perform I've Loved and Lost Again, which was her single at the time. She was 24. She was always very popular on the West Coast. What I notice about this performance is the almost pent-up physicality that you sense in Patsy. She had been used to moving around on stages a lot and really packing a wall up with live audiences, but for the television medium and for the country music broadcasting, you had to stand still. You had to perform stationary, and you can almost sense the tension there as she's, you know, singing the song. And as she's singing it, she's investing it with so much meaning. It's really not that great a song, but she's putting so much emotion into this, and that was part of her genius.
So here at Ranch Party, we're always delighted when we read about or hear about or see some young artist that gets on the move. And we have a little guest here, a little lady that great things have been happening to here for the past year or so. A young lady that is fast becoming one of the leading sellers on phonograph recordings. Many of you people have seen her on a lot of the coast-to-coast radio and TV shows, seen and heard her. Let's give her a real Western welcome to Miss Patsy Cline.
I've loved and lost again.
I ask you, what chance have I? When each love I meet just makes me cry. He loves a while, then says goodbye. I've loved and lost again.
In 1957, the most popular television show in the United States was Arthur Godfrey's Talent Scouts. Patsy Cline went on the program and on January the 21st, 1957, won. She won with a song that she didn't particularly like. She had been forced to record Walkin' After Midnight by her record label and her producer. She dismissed it as just a little old pop song. She thought she wanted something much more harder country than that. But her producer, Owen Bradley, heard that straight-ahead B-flat blues and knew how to make it swing, and did. And as a result, Patsy Cline got her first top 10 hit record.
Along the highway.
Patsy had been performing lovesick blues in her live shows for years, and I think what you'll see on this clip is the supreme confidence that she has with this piece of material. I mean, she owns this song. It's a measure of her fearlessness that she would take a number that Hank Williams had immortalized in 1949 and was so identified with it, and yet she could make it so completely her own. She makes you love every note of this song.
Now let's make welcome our favorite singer around the community jamboree as she sings the lovesick blues, Miss Patsy Cline.
Feeling 'cause I'm blue. Oh Lord, since my baby said goodbye, I don't know what I'm gonna do. All I do is sit and cry. Oh Lord, that last long day he said goodbye. Oh Lord, I thought I would die. Hallelujah, hallelujah, he's got the kind of loving. But Lord, I love to hear him when he calls me sweet baby. What a beautiful dream. I hate to think it all over. I lost my heart at sea. I've grown so used to that man somehow. And I'm nobody's sugar baby now. 'Cause I'm lonesome. I got the lovesick blues. Now I'm in love with the wonderful guy. That's what's the matter. Well, I'm in love with the wonderful guy, but he don't care about me. Well, I tried and I tried to keep him satisfied, but he just wouldn't stay. But now that he is leaving, this is all I've got to say. I got a feeling 'cause I'm blue. Oh Lord, since my baby said goodbye,
a whole battle with Patsy Cline. She perceived herself to be a gut bucket hillbilly country artist, and her producers perceived her to have pop potential, and there was a constant tension between the types of songs that she sang. How Can I Face Tomorrow, which she did in 1960, it's probably the countryest of the early records. This really shows, I think, her in her most natural element, where she felt most comfortable.
Well, we're going to keep things rolling right along here with a young lady who sings with the best of them. She's one of my favorites, Patsy Cline.
But we, their times are blue.
time in Nashville when giants walked the earth? When you're listening to these people, you're listening to people who sang live, who performed live in the studio with the musicians. When you're listening to a Patsy Cline record, you are listening to a live performance. People don't do that anymore. People can't do that anymore. And that is why Patsy Cline is the standard by which all female vocalists must measure themselves to this day. It all came together for Patsy Cline in 1961 with I Fall to Pieces. This is the first time where she truly masters the Nashville sound, the cushioning voices of the Jordanaires, the bell tone ringing of Hank Garland's guitar, the beautiful arrangement. All of it is there, and yet she resisted it. She felt that she should sing the song in her traditional sis boom ba up ending, and they said, no. The song, you're capturing an intensity, an emotional intensity. Keep it pent up inside like that, and keep it restrained, and that's what gives the record its magic. She hated the song. She felt it was used goods because Roy Drusky and Brenda Lee had turned it down. And if it's not good enough for them, why should she sing it? And so she made a deal with Owen Bradley that if he'd let her sing one of her Red Hot Mama songs, Lovin' in Vain, she'd record I Fall to Pieces. The rest is history. Television performances say that they don't nearly capture how great she was live. One of the ones I like to think might just a little bit is her performance of San Antonio Rose. She is so hot on this. She loved the song. She'd been performing it live for years, and the confidence just leaps out of the screen at you on this. I mean, she really knows what she's doing with this. It's a Bob Wills standard, and yet she makes it completely her own. She just swings like nobody's business.
I guess it's just about time that we sort of liven things up a little bit more and make things a little prettier around here, too. So let's give a great big welcome to pretty little Patsy Cline.
Deep within my heart lies a melody, a song of old saddened tone, where in dreams I live with the memory beneath the stars all alone.
Patsy Cline could paralyze audiences with her ballads. She'd get out there and sing, and before she was through, people didn't even know what had hit them. She was so intense, just riveting as a stylist. There's probably no greater example of that than Crazy. You hang on every note of this performance. You listen for every breath. She's inhabiting this song and wringing every drop of emotion out of it. I Fall to Pieces may have been the breakthrough, but it's Crazy where Patsy Cline finds Patsy Cline.
Crazy, I'm crazy for feeling so lonely.
Songwriter Hank Cochran was singing alone one night, and out fell She's Got You in like a 10 or 15 minute period. It just, blam, just came out of him. He was looking at somebody's picture, and I've got your picture, and he's got you, and he calls Patsy Cline up, and he says, I've got a hit. She says, bring it over here, let's hear it. And so over a bottle of whiskey, he taught it to her at her house. Once they had mastered it, she called Randy Hughes, her manager, and sang it over the phone. He loved it. The next day, they played it for producer Owen Bradley. He loved it. But there was another hurdle to overcome. She had difficulty recording it. This time not because she couldn't master the melody or figure out the phrasing, but because she was so emotionally invested in the song, she kept breaking down during the session. Patsy Cline was famous for weeping when she got inside a lyric, and that's part of her magic. That's part of her mastery. She doesn't just sing this song, she inhabits it. She lives it. She tells this story as though it's part of her life. And like so much of what Patsy Cline did, you hang on every line.
I've got your picture that you gave to me, and it's signed with love, just like it used to be. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got your picture. She's got you. I've got the records that we used to share, and they still sound the same as when you were here. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got the records. She's got you. I've got your memory, or has it got me? I really don't know, but I know it won't let me be.
this ring that proved you care, and it still looks the same as when you gave it, dear. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got these little things, she's got you. I've got your memory, or has it got me? I really don't know, but I know it won't let me be. I've got your class ring that proved you care, and it still looks the same as when you gave it, dear. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got these little things, she's got you.
There are times when you're listening to Patsy Cline where it feels like time stands still. She holds you in her heart while she sings. One of the hold your breath moments for me is So Wrong. It's a performance that is even more extraordinary on television than it is on record. You'll notice that she has a handheld mic, but she's holding it fairly far away from her mouth. And that to me says how much effortless power was in this voice. Carl Perkins was singing it when she was out on the road with him. She heard it backstage, and when he was writing it, she said, "Whose song is that?" And he said, "It's mine." And she said, "No, it's mine." And it is. It's Patsy Cline at her most breathtaking.
That pretty introduction means only one thing. It's time for our pretty girl vocalist, Miss Patsy Cline, to sing a great song that she has for the deck of people, So Wrong.
I've been so I was wrong.
On March 5, 1963, the small plane carrying Patsy Cline, manager Randy Hughes, and her fellow country stars Hawkshaw Hawkins and Cowboy Copas crashed in rural Tennessee while en route home to Nashville. There were no survivors. Patsy Cline was dead at age 30. Nashville was stunned into grief and silence. There was talk of canceling the Grand Ole Opry that weekend. Instead, Patsy's vocal backup group, the Jordanaires, bravely sang gospel music in her memory. Instead, Minnie Pearl walked out and told jokes through her tears. Instead, the show went on. Country music had lost one of the greatest voices in its history. But in a sense, Patsy Cline has never died. Neither the public nor the music world has ever forgotten her. And as long as there are listeners to hear her immortal songs, she will continue to hypnotize them with the rapture in her voice. Her musical legacy is sealed forever in these television clips, as well as in her records. And her personal legacy is in her family. Husband Charlie Dick, her children Julie and Randy, and an extended family that is now four generations deep. In years to come, there will be hundreds who will be proud to call Patsy Cline their ancestor. The rest of us will simply be eternal fans.
Instead of having sweet dreams of love.